From the back alleys and streets of Detroit comes a brand new show about music, comedy, art, and rebirth. This is The Box. I wanted to find some way as a storyteller in a world where we don't listen to each other anymore, that we could start seeing each other through one another's eyes. Mm-hmm. And thus, The Box was born. Hi, I'm Kirk Dolan, and welcome to The Box, and welcome to Behind the Scenes of the building of my show, The Box, a living documentary. And I've really been thinking a lot about the building of this show, and part of it that makes it very difficult for me to build is that I'm really building a show based on two lives now. Because I've lost a lot of memory from that first Kirk and a lot of context and reference points about what happened and how I got to this place. And so I have to review a lot of footage and go through this immense library of video that I have created over the years and sort of look at some of the stories and try to figure out through those breadcrumbs what kind of went wrong maybe, or just to get a better understanding of who I was in comparison to who I am becoming today. So each week I'm gonna try to give you kind of a walkthrough on some of the stories that have really affected me as I watched them. A lot of things that have happened in my life, because wow, this life has been the life of some kind of Shakespearean character. It has had its great highs and really incredible lows. But to be honest with you, I wouldn't have it any other way. I really wouldn't. I've learned so much about life and I have so many great memories. I think that is one of the reasons why we become comedians, is when it's all over with, when it's all said and done, when you're no longer the young man and the young talent that everybody is looking for, when you're no longer relevant in the grand scheme of things, the things we have left are our stories. And my stories are the things that have helped me to survive this aftermath, this tsunami of epic proportion that came through and just devastated my life and left it in pieces. It is through the art of storytelling that I found my way again. And that's why it's so important for me to share this with others. I want to be able to help others tell their stories, because I can see how important being able to tell my stories and share them has helped heal me.
What was your motivation to get you to decide to go another route? What made you go that route and not necessarily to comedy?
One thing, to be perfectly honest and to be perfectly frank, I have not felt funny for a very, very long time. Okay. I didn't feel funny anymore. This broke me, and nothing was funny anymore to me at all. And you combine that with, I couldn't remember my act. I was also looking, because of that memory loss, I was looking at another life. Mm-hmm. I mean, who is that complicated person? And the only thing I had were those breadcrumbs that I had left for myself to be able to look at those things and then start to sort of go, okay, am I brave enough to go down this road? Because part of it was, I don't want to lose it again. Mm-hmm. And I wasn't sure then, at the beginning of this journey now, I wasn't sure about how much the drugs had sent me down that road. And I can say today, the medication is what sent me over the edge. It is why when people look at me and go, wow, you tried to kill yourself? You're the last person I expected. Even the strongest of warriors can be taken down by the darkness, and we forget that.
Is a damaged life and a broken soul any less worthy than one that has never been broken at all? It reminds me of the ancient Japanese pottery art of Kintzugi, which is how you take damaged things and you repair them and make them look even more beautiful than they were before. And that's what I'm going to attempt to do here with my life now. I'm going to attempt to use the art of Kintzugi and pick those pieces up one by one in telling my story and try to put them back together again.
I can't believe you tried to kill yourself, Kirk. You're the strongest person I ever knew. Even the strongest people can get taken down by the darkness. Maybe by telling my story, people won't end up like me right now.
I'm on suicide watch, and literally they sent two 17-year-old girls in, one sitting on one side of the bed, and the other one sitting on the other side of the bed.
I cry.
The one thing, the one quote that kept coming to my mind was Hamlet. You can take nothing from me that I don't give you except my life. You realized even you couldn't take your own life.
Never would have imagined in a million years it could turn around so much.
The year that I lost my mind. It's not easy starting all over again, but it's worth it. It is. Because where I'm at now, wow, I never thought I would be here. You know, the world can be what you make of it. It really is. And I'm trying to make the best of it this time around.
Hi, I'm Kirk Nolan. I am backstage. I am producing my one-man show, The Box, a living documentary. And I'm going over footage and looking at pieces of my previous life. This immense catalog of video that I've made throughout the years. And trying to figure out which pieces are going to work for the show and which pieces aren't going to work for the show. But every time I look through this catalog, it's hard for me because it is what my life was. I mean, where all of these things, these wonderful things, these stories that have happened in my life. And so some of them are really hard to watch and some of them are funny and, you know, I didn't even realize how funny of a comedian I really was until I started looking at a lot of the footage. So, you're here with me now, behind the scenes, as I'm building my one-man show. And if you look behind me, you can see pieces of my set behind me. One is Robin Williams. And Robin has followed me everywhere. He's followed me all over the country and followed me through the worst times, and he is a reminder to me on stage every night that even the greatest genius since Charlie Chaplin can be taken down by the darkness.
Right.
So the only thing that you can really help people to understand is that you have to keep vigilant of your mental health, especially during these really trying and problematic times that leaves so many people scared of just the next day and the uncertainty of what's going to happen. You have to just keep a dream alive. And that's what I'm doing here. And that's what Robin reminds me every day, is you just keep the dream alive.
You know, as we come to the end of this phase of our life, we find ourselves trying to remember the good times and trying to forget the bad times. Find ourselves thinking about the future. You start to worry, thinking, what am I going to do? Where am I going to be in 10 years? But I say to you, hey, look at me. Please, don't worry so much. Because in the end, none of us have very long on this earth. Life is fleeting. And if you're ever distressed, cast your eyes to the summer sky. When the stars are strung across the velvety night, and when a shooting star streaks through the blackness, turning night into day, make a wish. Think of me. Make your life spectacular. I know I did.